So radical validation is a concept. It's kind of a combination between radical genuineness and radical acceptance. And radical genuineness is used to help people understand how to treat family members and loved ones with mental illness, you know, with love, and see them, you know, as people who are capable of getting through those things. Radical acceptance is, you know, accepting where you are right now radically, you know, that, but also understanding, and there's things that you might need to change, you know, or there's things you need to change. And so trying to take a concept of radical genuineness and radical acceptance and kind of combining it to create radical validation. And radical validation, you know, validation is a big part of DBT, dialectical behavior therapy, and it's a wonderful communication strategy to improve how you show understanding to the people that we're talking to. And so really, the concept of radical validation is to seek understanding before you seek to be understood, you know, and really understand that when we've hurt someone in addiction and you've had an addiction, or you've had, you know, problems caused, you know, because of your mental health or because of the actions that you've done and you've hurt your family members, it's not easy to be able to listen to their reenactment of that experience, you know. And a lot of times with drug addicts and alcoholics, we don't remember the things that we did when you were on drugs or you were drunk. And so the family member's telling you the story and it brings up, you know, a frustration, one, because it happened a long time ago, and two, because you don't remember it. And so to put it in perspective and have a calmer, more successful, understandable experience for, you know, the person that's in recovery as well as the family member, you know, we use radical validation. And so if someone is experiencing or expressing a conversation about some incident that occurred in the past, whether it was drugs and alcohol or it was a mental health issue, you know, the individual that is getting attacked for their actions, the concept is to, one, actively listen, you know, and pay attention and make eye contact, you know, and pay attention to the person that's speaking, you know. Don't get in a mindset of defensiveness or, you know, rationalizations or reasons. And in this moment, the radical validation is to radically and only focus on what the person is saying and what their experience is, and to validate that, and to look at them in their eyes and say, I understand what you're saying. You know, I know that I hurt you when I did that, you know, and I don't want to do it again. Don't make any excuses, because if you make excuses and you make reasons and you try to tell them what was going on at that time, you know, and what all the things that were happening, and they're real reasons. But in that moment, that person's experience is being invalidated when you do that. And we have to validate their experience and say, I know you were worried when I didn't call you for 3 years. I know you were worried when I went to the psychiatric hospital, you know, and you didn't hear from me and you didn't know what was going on. You know, I know that worried you and I'm sorry, you know, not everything else that was going on. And so we have to be radical, and radical is really extreme, you know, and validation is not explaining your side, you know. And so if you can be radical and you can actively listen and you can totally express understanding to the person and what they experienced and something that you did, like it's not something you didn't do. We're not talking about a lie here. We're talking about something you really did. And if you really did it, then you have to be able to really be accountable for it. And how do you do that? You look at the person and you say, I understand what I did, you know, and I'm sorry, I'm not going to do it again. Because then what happens is the person who experienced that doesn't have to repeat it. Because if it gets repeated, the message only gets more harsh. And it only gets harder on our part to be able to respond in a validating way. Because then we get defensive, you know, and we get aggressive. You know, if somebody's disrespectful, the disrespectful lady, you know, it's plus one, and one, and one. You know, I'm going to one-up you. You know, don't one-up, you know, one down and validate, you know, radically, you know, and be able to express understanding for those situations. Because when you validate and somebody gets that you understand what you put them through, or the feeling that they had with what they experienced, maybe you didn't put it through them, you know, maybe it's just their feelings about what happened, you know, and it's not your fault either, you know, but they had an experience. Validate their feelings. They don't have to repeat it anymore. And then they might be open to want to understand your experience, because you had an experience too. And if you practice validation and radically validating people, then people can validate you when you express your experiences and how you felt about what you went through. But if you try to shove your experience down somebody's throat when they're trying to share theirs with you, then the invalidation creates conflict, misunderstanding, and for anybody who's in addiction, it's an increased risk for relapse. For anybody who experiences any mental health issues, it's a severity increased risk for severe emotions up or down, whichever way it is. You know, when there's conflict and misunderstanding, your mental health and your addiction is not going to be stable, and you have to be able to see that this is something we could do. This is something you could change. The way you communicate, the way you look at people, the way you listen. You know, and you want to listen more? Ask questions. That's how you radically validate people. You don't give excuses. You ask questions about what they said or what they felt, or tell me more. What happened next? How did you feel about that? You know, and when you tell people and show people that you understand, and it's radical, understanding is healing, and healing is the goal. And if you heal and you're understood, then we're gonna be able to be better, and we're gonna be able to move forward and get through the things that we went through and learn from them, and not be able to create those same mistakes. Hope you have a great day.